Any one of you, please drop a message in the group and ask others to join in so that we can quickly start it and finish it in time. All right, I'll be starting it now. So good afternoon, everyone. So I hope you all remember that when we kick-started our journey to virtual school, we started using Microsoft Teams and we were doing a collaborative meeting on Teams. Am I audible? Just a sound check.
Yes.
All right. So the thing is that we started our journey with Teams and we were using it as a collaborative platform. That time it was too haphazard that we just switched to it, and then we became, you know, so comfortable with Google Classroom for conducting the classes. Even though if we will be resuming back to physical learning, there are certain things which we have taken from these challenging times. And one of the thing that has come as a blessing in disguise is the use of technology to make the learning go, right? So this is something which we will carry forward. To this end, what I would like to, you know, add on that, yes, Google Classroom is a good LMS, but when it comes to, you know, deal with other, areas of teaching and learning, there is still a scope of improvement. Wherein Microsoft technologies are very well aligned with what we do when it comes to primary, be it, you know, inclusive education or collaboration or, you know, use of different tools to understand student understanding. So that has been taken care very well by Microsoft. So I'm not going to switch you to Microsoft because any more changes in between is not welcoming either for students nor for you guys. But what my plan is that before we resume back to, next year, we should be more well equipped with Microsoft tools and technology, right? So that we can apply for being, you know, a Microsoft Showcase school. And we can leverage all these resources, which are very well aligned with IBPYB philosophy, into our classroom. This is what I'm expecting to. So don't be in a fear that we are going to switch to Microsoft, nothing as such. On the other hand, it is very, very beneficial for you because you can get certifications from Microsoft. And you will be updating and upskilling yourself when it comes to infused technology in your classroom. So this is the whole idea. Today we will be just, getting a hang of it. And you will be just understanding how can we leverage this in our classroom. At the end of the meeting, I'll be sharing a code. You can redeem that code to get your certificates for today's training, right? So I will be conducting few more trainings, not as certain with the dates, but yes, I'll be doing it. So moving ahead with that, so I have set the context that what we are doing and why we are doing. So as I told you, remote learning, keeping student engaged, building strong student-teacher connection in a remote learning environment. So what do you wonder about the topic? I would like to see your responses that what do you wonder about the topic? Use a peer tag and just let me know what do you wonder about the topic. All right, some very good responses are coming up. It may be about making the remote learning more interactive and resourceful. I would like to know how to use it in online teaching and learning platform, how Microsoft can promote in interactive classroom, some new strategies and tools we can apply in our class. I was wondering maybe another way of improving our skills to implement in our teaching and learning. All right, so a lot many wonderings are there and some predictions are there. Thank you so much for responding. We're moving ahead now. So this is a slide which I would have been using if I would be conducting it for some other people, but yes, you know me all. All right. So what are the objectives that we are, you know, the big ideas that we are looking up in this session is learn about types of team you will need in your remote learning experience and how to create them. Learn how to use Stream to manage and share your videos with students, and how OneNote Classbook can allow you to share resources with students and evaluate their understanding. So these are the three big key ideas that we'll be exploring today. So so the agenda will be creating a team for your class, record and edit lessons, creating virtual office hours, posting assignments using Class One Notes, and promoting fun, right? This session has been planned for an hour. Basically, we know remote learning very well, right? We have been doing remote learning since long. It has started in the month of March, and now we are still, you know, polishing our skills and becoming better day by day. So remote learning, there are different types of learning, you know, distance learning, online learning, hybrid learning. So when do we call it remote learning? So when the learner and instructors are, you know, and source of information are separated by time and distance. For example, you're sitting in Noshingvi and there are students which are, you know, in remote areas, right? And the source of information also is distant, right? There are teachers who are sitting in Dhaka. So this particular type of learning can be leveraged during the time of pandemic as we are in. There are countries and people which are leveraging it even before the pandemic. And it is actually a cost efficient way if we have enough resources, right? Because, you know, learning should never stop. So this is one solution which we can implement and incorporate in case there are barriers in learning when it comes to time and distance. Right, how is online learning different? It is different. So I want you to use the chat box. Other than these three points, learners rely on the facilitator to bridge the physical distance that separates the participants. Social dynamics are the same, but implications are different. Content can feel static and distant. So these are the things that has been given by Microsoft. But what do you say? Use the chat box. How is online learning different? You requested to use the chat box to share your ideas about the differences that you have observed in online learning. Although three are stated, but there are many. So basically, when we talk about online learning, the biggest factor which is there is the distance, right? The physical distance that separate the participants. When I say participants, it includes both teacher and students. So what is hindering? Student-teacher relationship, right? Student-student relationship and student connect with the content. These are the three things which has to be bridged up when it comes to online learning. So these are considered as the biggest obstacles. So how can we bridge this gap? Basically, when we talk about bridging this gap, we need to consider building community. So as we could see, in the first slide, which talks about the topic of this presentation, is like building, you know, better relationships. So it is, you know, still emphasizing on developing relationship to bridge this gap. Now, secondly, it is talking about, you know, the facilitator has to replace the physical cues with the virtual cues. Although in virtual course, the content can feel static and distant, right? So even, you know, when it comes to content which you share during your class, it seems vague to students. Seth, someone is scribbling. I think it's you or someone else. So avoid to do that. So these are the thing that we come across, and these are the proven to be the, you know, biggest obstacles which creates a kind of gap in learning. All right, so how satisfied are you as a teacher with online learning? I want you to share your responses. Well done. So most of you are in good zone now because we have been practicing it. All right, moving ahead now. So what type of teams do we need? I hope you remember when we created our teams, we created teams for, you know, MWC, we created team for GSCM, we created teams for grade level, and we created teams for each class. So in the same way, it is stated that different types of teams needs to be created with different agendas. For example, a grade KG2 team has to be created where green and red section can collaborate, join call, discuss upcoming session, regular checks, and they can leverage the technology in a fear-free environment, because there are only teachers who are implementing and seeing, are they able to use Teams effectively? Second type of team is a class team. For example, one team for KG2 green and other team for KG2 red, for example. Other than that, there should be staff teams where all the staff members are there. So we have leveraged all type of teams. But before creating teams, we need to be very clear that what is the basic purpose of each team, right? So apart from that, now what we will be doing now when we will be using Microsoft for school, this time we will be having students also part of teams, right? So they will be the part of each team, which is the class team, right? Remaining team will be comprises of teachers, leaders, right, to collaborate and to carry on the learning. So different type of teams will be needed when we'll be leveraging Microsoft Teams. Okay, one of the most important feature of team is announcement. We do have announcement in Google Classroom, but there's little difference when it comes to this announcement. So announcement are actually a wonderful way to provide a visual reminder to students about any upcoming assignments or activities, right? Because the announcement feature allow you to add a colorful banner or an illustration to your post. For example, there are early learners, those who cannot read, right? For example, there are learners who understand visual cues better. So for that, you can color code your assignment. As you can see, one flashing on the screen is dioramas are due tomorrow. So teacher has made this announcement and she must have color coded. So probably green is the color for science or green is the color for arts. Right, so you can color code your assigned announcement and you can use the same banner as many times as you know needed. Now we will be looking into starting a team call today. I'm not playing any videos. Better we will be just go through, have a walk around what we will be up to. Then we will see some videos. I'll be sharing the tutorials and all. So starting a team call. So as you all know, we now also we are leveraging both synchronous and asynchronous way of learning. There are recorded classes, there are live classes, there are home packets being sent. So we are leveraging both synchronous and asynchronous mode of learning. So synchronous meeting with your students are easy with the Meet. Now feature in Meet, Microsoft Teams, you can start a call for an immediate meeting. For example, right now, if you think that you want to meet your students, especially in higher classes, you can quickly create a Meet link and you can send it as an announcement for a meeting. That feature is there. Although, you know, you may not decide the majority of your remote learning will be conducted asynchronously, but still, you know, there are students who want asynchronous, are more flexible with that because their parents have different working hours and all those things. So it is also being taken care by Teams. So Teams call is an option. We earlier have used Teams call for our collaboration as well. So right inside the Teams itself, you can create channels and all those. If you remember, if you go back and just refresh your memories, we have used it all. Right, so some of the class management tips, I want you to pause and read it out. Not read aloud. So just read it. What tips has been given, that initial Meet, student to mute themselves, blah, blah. These are some of the stuff that we are doing and we can do to manage the class well. I really like this point. Create checkpoints where you pause to gauge understanding, right? I already spoke about this, that it is very important to have checkpoints. Right, a point where you think that it is important to gauge understanding. And if the people whom I'm working with to make planners, and we are rectifying some of our planners which are already done, we are talking about ongoing formative assessment. So when these checkpoints are all means your informal formative assessment. Strongly encourage a student to consider sitting at a table of your calls. It's very much encourage that students have a, you know, night clean and tidy setup and they're sitting in a good posture while attending the call. It has been observed that some of the students, they don't do that. So, you know, it's all about setting up your routines. And I really like this pointer as well, that remember, attention span will be shorter than if you were in face-to-face classroom. Already the attention span of students are, you know, has constraints, but if you are in a virtual setting, it becomes even more lesser, right? If you're using Microsoft Teams, we have again an advantage. Google Classroom is also downloadable and having as an app. Same as mobile, for mobile users, those who are conducting and attending the classes through mobile, we have the facilities and we are following a mandate that we'll be conducting our classes through laptop. But there are schools where teachers are also using mobile phone and students are also using mobile phones. So in that case, downloading the team apps is necessary. Right, so there are two ways of recording your lessons. Record team calls as they occur, like synchronously when it is happening, you can record it and you can share it with the students, those either are not available, not attending the lessons. They have requested that we will be, you know, attending, we will be submitting the assignment, but we won't be able to attend the live lesson. So you can record your meetings synchronously and you can share it across. The second one is record pre-recorded lessons, like the way you are recording your lessons and uploading it. So same way, this also give you same kind of flexibility, right? So this is again something which you can do. So use a team call to record your meeting. You can also use a PowerPoint recorder. Mr. Saif has Saif Islam has already sent an email long back that how you can use Microsoft PowerPoint recorder to record your meetings, right? So these are again some of the stuff that we had done and we have stopped doing. It's easy to do. Option for recording, you know, your asynchronous lesson, like I said, these are the several options which you can leverage. Use a team call, record a team call, or use your camera app to record, use a PowerPoint record. These are different ways to record. You can also use your screen recorder in stream, right? In the stream, you will have a screen recorder. You can use that as well. Editing and sharing videos. If you are, you know, all of us are editing and sharing videos, but we find it difficult to edit. So once you have recorded your lesson, you can use Microsoft Stream to share it, right? So sharing is there. And once you have created the stream channel, you make it easier for a student to find the channel by adding the tab in Teams. Teams have tabs as well. So, you know, there are different tabs which you can use and you can make your students familiar with those tabs. So it increases the accessibility. Student will not, just look into where it is. They will have things in place because you will be making them familiar that what you want and where you can find them. So the tab feature is really, really good in Teams. Apart from that, there'll be demos, but I'm not going to have the demos, video demos today. We will be using it. It is very important to create virtual office hours, which we have already done. Why is it important? When we talk about well-being, we need a routine. We shouldn't be, you know, working 24 hours or 18 hours or 12 hours if we are learning remotely. So it's important to have your virtual office hours set, and that also you can do with the team. So you can set up your routine and make others well informed about it. I spoke about gauge understanding. So formative assessment, we not only use the, you know, entrance ticket, exit tickets, there are different things that we can use, but those all can be used with Microsoft Forms in the post tabs of the team. Okay, journal entries in OneNote or Word document. Quick polls are also there. Discussion during the team calls can also be taken as a gauging understanding. Way, right? And the summative assessment in place of, you know, objective tests. We don't have tests, but there are schools which are following tests. So students, they themselves are recording teaching a concept, a peer teaching, or you know, considering themselves as a teacher and imagining a student is sitting. This is one of the wonderful way when you see students teaching the concept which they have, you have dealt in the class. Right. So responding to short answer questionnaire using the Word document or a OneNote page. Journaling and documenting their daily work. It is very important that they maintain a journal of their work and document their learning. Again, it is very well aligned with the BYP philosophy, which talks about, you know, monitoring, documenting. So what is documenting? Students, they themselves document what have they learned, and responding to Flipgrid prompts. We already have used Flipgrid. So it is one of the way to connect with the students when they are feeling that they are that side of the glass barrier. So it is important to develop a connect, right? Posting assignment is again an easy thing, and that you will learn once you start using it. in a more full-fledged manner once we will switch to Microsoft. So in the same way, you can have your assignment predated, or you can have an assignment assigned for a particular date, right? There'll be, for school who will be using the grades, you will find grades over there, then the title and all those things, and you can share the assignments with the learner. If you and your students are new to team, you will want to ease it to creating assignment, allow everyone time to adjust to the learning, right? Connecting the team calls, there'll be enough to learn. So it is very important to give students time to use the platform. Because when we can understand when it is difficult for us, it's going to be difficult for them also. So we need to give them a little time when we are starting sending assignments. Easing into a new way of working, allowing you and your student to learn the new tool. As you transition to remote learning, so this is the pointers which have started the remote learning. Now we have already transitioned to remote learning and we are finding ways to go back to school, right? So all those things has to be taken care if we are transitioning. So we have already transitioned. OneNote is a kind of binder, you know, it's your, what happened in Google Classroom, we don't have, you know, a place where we can see students' journal and there's notebook component which is missing, right? If we wanted, we want to have add-ons, but OneNote book is actually same as, you know, your classroom journals. So it helps you to see where the students are, and it is almost a replica of your classroom journals, classroom portfolios. So it is again a great thing. So for one notebook, you will be needing a full-fledged training that what it is, how to use it. Okay, in this, when we use Microsoft, this classroom Teams, Microsoft as an LMS, Microsoft Teams, it is again easy to see the data, and we can get well informed by the data, and that can reflect in our teaching and learning practices, right? We have started leveraging this literacy planet. What we can see, that we can see where is the level of a student, and that is something which is valid, right? And more valid than our observations. So same way, you can leverage this data to inform your teaching and learning practices. Interacting during a call, you can create small groups during a call. You can divide them into groups, right? In the same way, I'm using PeerDeck, but we are using Zoom now. You can use PeerDeck for active learning. And because PeerDeck and Kahoot is synced with the Microsoft Teams classrooms. So you can leverage all these tools during a call. It's just talking about the live classes, your synchronous classes. You can just create, you know, promote fun through these different ways. The classes has become, you know, monotonous. So you can have these kind of challenges, and you can even use it now. Don't wait for, you know, to use the Microsoft team. You can have a joke contest, but set up the, you know, guideline so that they don't come up with a joke which is not appropriate. Virtual talent show, appreciate nature challenge. Just look out what you can see out from the window, click a picture, share it with the virtual art gallery. All these things can be done even now, right? To make the classroom learning more fun. All right, I have reached to the end of the meeting. It is more of a talk show. For the first time I have done this, but this is important to set the context. Next, when we'll do, we will have videos and something to apply on. So I have just briefed you about what it is and how to leverage it, right? So in 1 minute, I want you to write the most important thing from today's session, and then I'll be giving you a code. Please redeem that code today itself. Otherwise it will get expired, to have your certificate. And once you have redeemed, please confirm. All right, so please share your responses. In the meanwhile, when you're writing, I should share with you that One Notebook is a fabulous tool. What it can do, why is it so fabulous? So it is like a digital three-ring binders. When I say three-ring binders, the One Notebook, Class Notebook has a content library for sharing content and resources with students, a collaboration space where everyone in the class can work together, student section where a student can complete the individual work and teachers can share feedback. So it has it all, right? As if they are sitting in the class in front of you, right? So it is therefore One Notebooks, you know, allow to digitally hand out all the resources. This is again one good thing. And you can take existing Word document, PowerPoint, PDF, and organize the material by unit, right? All the unit things can be well arranged and you can just drag and drop to the students. So I'll be texting the code, or I request you to it is actually a very fabulous tool, and you will find that it is how well aligned with the PYP philosophy. So I will be introducing in the introductory part, it will be more, you know, me talking and you listening. So we will be doing it and, you know, getting to know what all is there. So I hope you all have created your Microsoft accounts. Make sure that you're using the school domain, because in the training, I have only entered the school domain. It will not accept any other domain. So Saif has prepared two videos. See those videos. He has prepared one video to have an account and another video to redeem the code, right? So redeem the code when you will go to your Teams. You will be able to redeem the code. Great responses. Thank you so much. And I'm hopeful that we will make our even physical classes more better using it, because we have devices with students. All right, I'm done for today. Okay, if you wish to share or if you have any question, you can ask me. You can unmute and ask if you have any questions. Next, most probably I want to look into how Microsoft Teams make the class more inclusive, and some, you know, implementation part I would like to look into. But before that, we would like to set the context at what all is available, right? Last time we used it in a haphazard manner, but this time we will take a well-informed decision, and it will be good for you because you will be getting certificates. You will become certified Microsoft educators, and it will be really great for you. I will be sharing the code in the WhatsApp chat. Thank you so much. Take care. Have a nice day. Thank you.